3, 2, 1. Hello, massageners. Today we're going to be doing lesson 11, part 2. These are the muscles of the vertebral column movement. And on the first part, we did the abdominals, the four abdominals, and those are for flexion. We went over that on the first lesson. So today I'm going to focus more on the extension and the lateral rotation, lateral flexion and rotation. So I drew the muscles each on both sides. Now these are considered the paraspinal muscles. Paraspinal muscles means that they're next to the spine and they're broken down into two different ones. These will be the transversospinalis and this will be the erector spinae. And there's three sets of muscles on each one. So there's six layers right here of muscles around between the two, because remember they are on both sides. We also have the quadratus lumborum, that's also on both sides. So I'm going to take one section at a time, because most of the time we just say erector spinae and we forget that there's really three muscles to the erector spinae. So the erector spinae are these right here. The fibers run lengthwise like this. And so the way I like to teach it to my students so they can remember is I like to teach them like, I love spaghetti. I love spaghetti. The I will be for the iliocostalis, which is the most lateral. And that one originates at the sacrum and at the iliac crest, and it goes all the way up to C4, and as you can tell, it inserts, you know, on the ribs all the way up. Okay, so this one inserts on the ribs, and it's the most lateral. And also the erector spinae are the most superficial. They lay over the transversal spinalis. So then next to that you have the longissimus. The longissimus also originates at the sacrum and the iliac crest, and it goes all the way up, and it from C7 goes all the way up to the mastoid process. So this one inserts at the mastoid process, and as you can see, it also inserts at the transverse processes of the, you know, from the thoracic and the lumbar. The lumbar, thoracic, and the cervical, okay? And then next to that, you have the spinalis. That's the one closest to the spine. That's why it's called the spinalis. And that one and starts like a T12, and then it inserts all the way up to like around C4. And they also insert in the spinous processes. So they go up to the spinous processes. The spinous processes is what you can feel. That bony ridge that you feel that you don't want to work on, because that's the one thing that we teach. Do not work directly on the spinous processes, because you have all these muscles right here from the transversal spinalis that, you know, that are originate and insert right there, and you could cut those little muscles. So this side, what's drawn on this side is the erector spinae, a set of three muscles. And on this side, I drew the transversal spinalis. So the first one that I drew would be the rotators. The rotators are the pink ones. And they are, you know, they originate from the transverse processes and go into the spinous processes of each one all the way up to C2. And these are diagonal. If you can notice the difference, these muscles are diagonal. So when they're diagonal, just kind of like the internal and external obliques that are diagonal fibers, what does that tell you? They're more for rotation. Okay, so these fibers are diagonal. These are more long. So then after the rotators, you have the multifidi. The multifidi are the blue ones in between. They're a little bit, they're medial, you know, these are deeper, these are a little bit more in between. And so they also go from the transverse processes, from T12 all the way up to C2. So they go in between each little vertebrae, you know, from the transverse processes to the spinal processes. And the purple ones are the most lateral of the transversal spinalis, and they are the purple ones, and they don't go all the way down. They only go up to about T9. So this one also originates from C2, and it goes all the way down to T9, and they are diagonal And again, they go from the transverse processes to the spinous processes. And the way you can remember these, like this one was I love spaghetti. Well, this one, you can't have spaghetti without the meat, the red meat sauce. So then this one would be the red meat sauce. The red for the rotators and the M for multifidi and the sauce for semispinalis. So red meat, you love spaghetti sauce with red meat sauce. And that's how you can remember, you know, all the transversospinalis and the erector spinae. So there are on both sides, you have a layer of six muscles because you do have both of these on both sides. So there's six muscles. And let's talk about the quadratus lumborum, which is your hip hiker. This muscle is very important for people that have low back pain. This one is the deepest, actually. It's deep underneath all of these. And oh, as a matter of fact, right here, the multifidi goes all the way to the iliac crest, but the semispinalis, you know, does not. This one originates at the iliac crest, and it inserts on the floating rib and then the lumbars 1, 2, 3, 4. And the way you can get to this muscle is you can work on it from the side. Here's, you know, the soft meaty part. If you feel the bone right here, you're on the lower rib, so you don't want to work on that too much. And if you feel the iliac crest, then that's the bony part. But the soft part right there, that's the belly of the quadratus lumborum. And this muscle is responsible for a lot of low back pain. So you want to make sure and work this out. A lot of times they think, you know, like people that have thought they have more serious issues with their low back, thinking, you know, because it's right in the lumbar area, they're thinking, you know, they might have stenosis or, you know, herniated disc. A lot of times it's that muscle when they feel the pain. So you want to work on it, you know, coming from the side. This is a great muscle to work when your client is sidelined. You can really get to this muscle. Be careful with the insertions and the origins. You can really work at this muscle. And I want to talk to you about the tools. I have these tools that are handmade. And these tools are the ones that I use. I have the bevel bar and the flat bar. But the bevel bar is the one that I use to make sure and get to, you know, to the muscles right here that are so close to the spine. You can, you know, you put it at 40 degree angles, and you can go all the way up, you know, 1 inch at a time or a quarter of an inch at a time to really get to all these muscles right here without hurting and without doing any damage. And if you're gonna go in between each one, you can go horizontal, you know, but you must feel where the spinous processes are, and then you just go right in between to get to all these little muscles. And this is a great little tool. This is how one of the things that I use to get to all these muscles when people are having problems with extension or flexion, you know. So you want to work this, and you can also use it for the quadratus lumborum right here. You know, it really gets to this muscle. This is another, the quadratus lumborum is another muscle that a lot of people, when they come in, they might think that they have kidney problems, or I've had that. They think that because it hurts here, that, you know, that it could be their kidney. So you want to make sure, as long as they don't have a fever and they have other symptoms of kidney issues, it, you know, it probably more than likely is the quadratus lumborum. So I wanted to tell you about the tools in case you guys want to get them, because people have asked me, and the link is below. That's the, you can buy at my store at massagetherapeutics915.com. And also, some people have been asking about the markers, because they like, you know, to use, you know, to make it look colorful. And these are the body markers that I've been using. These are temporary tattoo body mark by Bic. And I'm going to include the link below too, in case you want to get them from Amazon. That'll be easier. And these, you know, they're a little more challenging to take off than the washable markers, but this really helps, you know, the students to learn how to, you know, where the muscles are when they draw them. So let's talk about the flexion and extension. And so for flexion, remember, that would be your abdominals, you know, moving you forward. That would be the rectus abdominis and The psoas major, we talked about that in the last, in internal and external obliques. Now for once you're flexed, the extension would be, okay, extension would be these muscles pulling you back up straight. So the extension would be the quadratus lumborum, the semispinalis, the multifidi, and the rotators and the erector spinae group. Those are for extension. These muscles pull you back up. For lateral flexion, that would be the rectus abdominis, the external oblique, internal oblique, the quadratus lumborum, the semispinalis, multifidi, and the erector spinae group. Now for rotation, these are these diagonal little muscles. That would be the internal and external oblique and the transversospinalis, which is, you know, transversospinalis is all these three, you know, all these three muscles. So as you can see, that's why they are diagonal. The fibers are diagonal because they're going to pull you for rotation. So there you have the flexion, extension, lateral flexion, rotation. And this is the end of our lesson 11. We're really done with kinesiology. And I'll do a short little video on the respiratory muscles, which is the diaphragm, which is real, you know, so internal, it's hard to draw. But I'll give you a little, you know, just a little summary of that. So I really appreciate you guys' time. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you, Leo. Turn around and say hello. And I appreciate Leo always being so willing to help me out. And until the next, guys, next time, create a great day. Stand here for a minute.